We know that our bottomland hardwood habitat, the area along the Mississippi River drainage, the Red River drainage, that's some of our farm country. It has bottomland hardwoods. We know that habitat, if a deer herd is properly managed and those animals have access to year-round agriculture, that's going to be high quality animals being produced in those areas if they're getting some age on them. Now, in a lot of our habitat where a lot of the forest has gone to a pine-dominated timber, the ability of that habitat to consistently produce large-bodied animals with big racks has been reduced. And hunters need to manage within the capabilities of the land. And so a lot of our habitat, particularly that pine-dominated habitat, may only produce a top-end buck that would score, say, 130. And to get that animal to the 160 level is going to take a lot of extra work, supplemental feeding, and a lot of clubs and landowners simply can't do that. So they kind of need to manage within the habitat now. But within those areas where you have the ability to do some good habitat work and where you have year-round agriculture, if you get age on those animals and you maintain that herd in balance with the habitat, there's good potential to produce some trophy-type animals out of there. We had 180 Boone and Crockett typical killed in Grant Parish a year or so ago, but Boone and Crockett deer are not common. I mean, that's something hunters need to understand. If you look, you know, they represent less than 1% of your total kill, a lot less than 1%. So it's just not an animal that is regularly produced. And so again, we try to emphasize to hunters to manage within the capabilities of your habitat. A lot of our habitat in the marsh country, you know, a 120 buck is a good animal. And if that's what your land can produce, be satisfied with that animal. So that's kind of the message you're trying to get out to the clubs and landowners. But this state has the ability to produce some nice deer, and we can compete with other states.